Our Philippines and Norway, we celebrate the holidays. And aside from Christmas, which is the traditional Yule, Christmas holiday, here in Norway we also celebrate New Year, Easter, and Labor Day, also the Constitution Day, which is equivalent to Independence Day in the Philippines. And also we have religious holiday, like here they also celebrate the holidays like in the Easter. And in the Philippines, of course, we also celebrate New Year and Easter, also the official Labor Day and Independence Day. And the good thing about you know, there's a very similar situation, like if it's Christmas in the Philippines, it's also Christmas here. So it's also, they also celebrate Father's Day, Mother's Day. So there's a big similarity between the two countries. Here in Norway, the weather is really very, very different from Philippines. Here they have four seasons. So they have winter, summer, spring, and autumn. So during winter, since we are located here in the north, it is really very cold. But the thing is that all you have to do is just wear the right shoes, the right clothes, put on jackets, and maybe three layers of clothing to protect you from the cold. Or you can just stay home or stay inside a building or a mall, so it will not be that cold. But also, there's a good thing about having a winter. Norway is very popular in winter sports. They go out, Norwegian, they love to go out during winter. They do skiing. There are many, many things that they do, even fishing. They do fishing, you know, in you know, when you do some skating, they can just put a hole and then they can fish. So, and in the Philippines, we have two seasons, the rainy and the summer season. And also, we have like equal day and night, like every morning the sun will rise around between 5:30 to 6, and in the evening the same thing, there's a sunset, and yeah, until the next morning. But here in Norway it's totally different, and I find it so amazing. During summer, you can experience, especially here in the north, you will experience longer days and maybe the longest day, you know, like 24 hours of no darkness. So daylight for 24 hours. And I said before, they called it white nights in other countries. I saw a movie in you know, in Russia. It's a Russian love story, and they called it white nights because they also have this kind of thing. And also during winter, it's the opposite. So daylight is very short. So even if you if it's only 3 p.m., it's already dark. So that's the big difference between these two countries. There are so many fish and many fish factories, so it's a big industry. They produce fish all over the world. So we have this Norwegian salmon and other fish like torsk, cod, and many other fish. So basically, Norwegian, they like to eat fish. They also like meat. They even have this whale meat, similar, the taste similar to beef. And well, we called it also beef. And also, yeah, many other like lump. In the Philippines, we don't eat too much of those, or we don't even have. I haven't tried eating lump in the meat of the sheep in the Philippines. So there are many choices of food, and it tastes similar to what we have in the Philippines. Here we also have the chicken, the beef, pork, and also other product of fi the fish product. And so those are the food. Hello everybody, and I am back, and this is the continuation of my part one, Pinay life in Norway. So it is not in general, as I can only speak for myself as a Filipina here in Norway. So I gave you, or I shared to you, some of my observation, and also I just pick some of it, of the most important thing for me. So as I go on, or I learn as I live day by day, and I really appreciate what Norway can offer. Actually, I've been so blessed, and I survived the cancer, and I am now telling this to everyone. Maybe the reason why I survive is for me to tell the story. But basically, Pinay life here in Norway, there are positive things, there are also negative things. Negative in a sense that it is different from what I got used to. But well, we learn from we also can learn from it and try to live, and life must go on here. And also, as a Pinay, for me, to make this the long story short, my observation and my conclusion is, I think my life here is much better, maybe 4 or 5 times better than what I have in the Philippines. The comfort, the peace, and also the nice system and health system in Norway. And my life and how I decide things is always based on what my doctor's findings. I don't know exactly what it is. Every day it might change, and I can see that they are doing doing their best to give me the right information, or give me different mulihetan possibilities that I can can use in order for me to decide what I would like to follow. So there are options, and also when looking back, I've been married for 10 years with a Norwegian, and it took me 9 years before I decided to stay here for good. I've been here many times just to visit and to see how it is here. one winter and one summer. So maybe the reason why my husband would like me to decide for myself, whether I can survive. My favorite song is really, I've been singing that in many occasions or gatherings of Filipina. My favorite song is I Will Survive, and I did. That's the thing. In that song, it says, "At first, I was afraid. I was petrified. Kept thinking I could never live being alone. But then I spent so many nights, so many days thinking how it did wrong. But I grow strong, and I learn how to get along. So here in Norway, I'm getting along. And I have a long-term goal. I also try to enjoy what the present. Present is the gift. So we don't know what will happen in the future. We don't know what we already know our past. So maybe we learn from it. The lesson we learn from it. We will just pick all the things that is applicable on our present time. So every day I enjoy the nice nature, nice people, the good system, and my freedom. And now I am sharing this to you all. And I hope you will follow my videos. And there are more things that I would like to share with you. My traveling in the past and here in Norway. And I'm planning to, go around Europe if things are safe for me. Of course, it will depend on what my doctors will say. If I am already ready to do it, I would like to go to Greece, Italy, Portugal, and also in Croatia, and maybe in Switzerland. So it's just nearby if I really would like to go and enjoy life, because this is my life after cancer. And I hope you like my video, and I am trying my best to give you more and exciting adventures of my journey to wellness. And everybody, thank you for watching. I love you all, and I hope to see you one day, and you can also visit me here. Bye bye. Thank you.